online experience. My name is Holly, and I was trying to make the tallest sand tower I could to show you guys, but every time I build the sand up, it just comes crumbling right back down. Maybe if I added some glue into it and made it sticky, do you think that would work? That might get a little messy. You know what? I'm gonna keep thinking on it, but while I do, why don't we go say our memory verse together?
Let's say our memory verse together. All these insights come from the Lord whose plans are wonderful. Isaiah 28:29. Let's do it one more time. All these insights come from the Lord whose plans are wonderful. Isaiah 28:29. Thanks for practicing with me.
Great job saying our memory verse, friends. We here at the lab love to turn to our Bibles every week because we believe that it's God's words to us. Now, God had awesome, awesome plans, and that verse reminds us that God's plans are the best plans. Speaking of plans, our Bible story today is about two guys that made plans to build a house. Now, one of their plans went really good, and one of their plans went not so good. But I don't want to spoil anything, so we're gonna watch it together and you'll see what I mean.
Stories of the Bible, the parable of the two builders. This is Jesus.
Heyo!
Who is the Son of God and the Savior of the world. While Jesus was on earth, he taught everyone about God's love and healed people from their sickness. He did many miracles like walking on water.
Oh, hey guys.
And even raised people from the dead.
Wahoo!
One day, as he saw the crowds gathering, Jesus went up to the mountainside and sat down. His disciples gathered around him and he began to teach them. He asked them, "Why do you keep calling me Lord, Lord, when you don't do what I say? Anyone who listens to my teaching and follows it is wise."
Hey, I'm gonna build here.
I'm gonna build out there.
All right, suit yourself.
Like a person who builds a house on solid rock.
Oh, yeah.
When the floodwaters rise and break against that house, it stands firm because it was well built.
All good here.
But anyone who hears my teaching and doesn't obey it is foolish.
All right, hey, it's nice.
Like a person who builds a house on sand.
Uh-oh.
When the rains and floods come and the winds beat against that house, it will collapse with a mighty crash. When Jesus had finished saying these things, the crowds were amazed at his teaching.
Oh, I think I get it. My tower wasn't working because I tried to build it with shaky sand. I should have tried to build it with something strong, like maybe blocks. Oh, I think I have some of those. One second. Ta-da! Okay, let's try this one more time, but we're gonna use the blocks instead of the sand. Look at that! Oh, this tower is way bigger and way stronger than the one I tried to build with the sand. Why do you guys think that is? Because the blocks are nice and firm and strong, right? And the sand is the kind of shaky and unstable. Well, in that story that we just watched, friends, the two men tried to build a house. The one man built it on a rock. And what happened to his house? It stood strong. But what about the other man who tried to build his house on the sand? What happened to his house? It crumbled, didn't it? Because it wasn't on a very strong foundation. Well, you know, friends, that story reminds us of Jesus. Because when we build our life with Jesus, that's like building it on a rock, a strong foundation. Jesus keeps us strong and founded, but building our life without Jesus is kind of like building it on sand. It's not very stable, and we don't have that security of having Jesus in our life. Now, how do we actually get Jesus to be in our life? That's a great question. Well, we can pray and we can ask God to help us follow Jesus with all our hearts. In fact, why don't we pray together right now? And if you want to ask Jesus to be a part of your life, you can pray with me. All right, let's fold our hands and close our eyes together. Dear God, we thank you that you love us. We pray that you would come live inside our hearts and help us follow you and love you every single day. We pray this in Jesus' name, amen. Ah, amen, boys and girls. That is such a great prayer. And if you ask Jesus into your life, I think you should go tell somebody so they can celebrate with you and support you in that walk with Jesus. Now, God says that following him is the wisest choice we can ever make. So when we have Jesus first, then we are practicing being wise. All right, I'm gonna see you next week here at the lab. Have a great week, friends. Bye.